forget the little warning box comes on. Okay, now we'll see what our preview looks like, and then if we're in that corner, then we're good. I apologize for the delay. Okay.
Yeah.
Ready to go?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Okay. Sorry for the delay, Rube.
I forgive you. I forgive you.
All right, we're live.
Oh, we're live.
My apologies. We are live. Welcome, everyone.
You're apologizing that we're live?
I am apologizing that we're live. I'm sorry.
Yeah.
I'm sorry. All right.
Welcome to the Worst the Best podcast.
It's been... I got a bit of a frog in my throat, so I'm going to have to...
Speak a little French?
Yeah, I'm going to speak a little French. I'm going to have to work through this. All right, let's go,
You're a trooper.
Here. No. All right, so I think I've got this. I think I got this figured out.
We'd had a little bit of technical difficulties. When I say we, I had no way to contribute. I just watched. All right, but thank you. So yeah, welcome to the Worst the Best podcast. I'm one of your hosts, Ruben, and this handsome fellow here is my brother, Brian.
Yes, thank you, Ruben. It's really good to be here. One of our last episodes that we did was on conspiracy theories.
Yes.
And we just did the top 10 American theories, sure, or conspiracy theories. We picked the worst one from that. Do you remember what the worst pick was from that?
I don't.
It was the Holocaust.
Oh, yes. Yeah.
Okay. So we thought it'd be fun to do another conspiracy episode because, believe it or not, that was a very popular episode. I think people like conspiracy theories.
Sure.
I think they enjoy
it. Oh, yeah. Yeah, they're great.
And today we're going to keep it centered on celebrities.
Okay.
Okay. And so these are our top, I think it's 12 or 13. The title says here 15 celebrities, but I think we're doing 12 or 13 stories.
The reason why we're not doing the other ones is because they won't let us.
That's right. There were some other ones that we wanted to do, but they won't let us. So, Ruben, have you watched or looked at this list?
No.
Okay. So, as per normal, Ruben's going in cold. And I'm going to explain to Ruben kind of what the conspiracies are. It's pretty straightforward. We're not going to spend hours and hours of research on each one.
Nope.
We're just going to read the headline, talk about what the theory is, and at the end of this, we're going to say which theory we think is the worst.
So these are the best ones. We'll figure out which is the worst. If you're new to the podcast, welcome. It's about 20 minutes, and if you're old to the podcast, make sure you leave us a review.
Yeah, come say hi to us. We're live, you know. You can come chat. I'm just making sure we're there. Yeah, looking good. Okay, we're all good. All right, excuse me. I just got to drink a bit of my tea here because of that frog in my throat. Kermit the Frog is not one of the conspiracies.
Or is it? Okay, let's get this going.
Okay, yeah, sorry, Ruben. Jeez. Right, here we go. All right. The first conspiracy that we're going to talk about is Avril Lavigne is dead. Did you Have you heard of this one?
I know that her career was somewhat dead.
Yeah, I was waiting for that joke.
But
wow, you went to that right away.
She's coming up with a new album.
Oh, is she?
Oh, what are you getting at?
That she's been dead for over 14 years.
14 years is a long time.
Or now 16 years. Well, this title's old because she died.
It explains how Chad Kroeger married her.
Boy, you're getting all the jokes too quick. You got to build up to these jokes. So the joke is, or not the joke, the story is... The conspiracy is that she died in 2003 by suicide.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear
that. That after her big album came out and she was really popular, then her parents got divorced and her grandfather died.
That's sad.
That she committed suicide.
That's very highly unlikely.
I'm trying to tell you what the theory is. But you should be asking.
Statistically.
Yeah, but
it's mainly men that commit suicide.
Sure.
But I guess it's, it's a new generation. Women can do what men can do.
But do you want to know how this conspiracy was created? Like,
no, how do they figure this out?
So the first part is that she's not alive. That Avril Lavigne, that was the Avril Lavigne in 2003, she had a friend that was also her like doppelganger.
Oh, sure, yeah.
Yeah,
we're brothers, we look alike.
Sure, Ruben and I could be doppelgangers of each other. And this doppelganger's name is Melissa Vandella. And we'll just do a quick search here, you can see along here. Melissa Vandella.
Yeah.
And there it's come up right there. So here she is here. Here's what they say is that's what she looks like right now. That is Melissa Vandell and that is not Avril Lavigne.
So really there's two suicides that took place, or two deaths.
Right.
Because she would have to fake her own death. in order to leave all of her friends and family and then pursue a life as Avril Lavigne.
So,
you know what I mean?
Yeah, well, I know. This is where already I'm kind of not on board with this one. So apparently she got tired of being popular. She got depressed about the divorce, her grandfather passing. She committed suicide in the height of her career.
Sure, yeah.
And this friend slash stand-in took over her career. And there's videos online, go on YouTube about her singing differently, looks differently, all these other things. And I would attribute that to probably plastic surgery over the years. Just faces change from a young 20-year-old to a 30-year-old.
Yeah.
I mean, you and I...
She popped on the scene when she's like 17 or 16 or something like that.
Yeah, she's just a skater girl. But now apparently she's a dead girl. So that's conspiracy theory one that... We're not saying if it's true or not at this point. We're just saying that is the conspiracy theory that Avril Lavigne is dead, and she has, for the past 16 years, had a stand-in for her.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
All right. Do you know who Lorde is, or is it Lordy? Sure. Is it Lorde or Lordy?
Oh, one of the two.
So her conspiracy is that she's not 20-ish, that she's 40-ish.
Okay. Wow.
So the... This 20-year-old
is very flattering.
Yeah, is emotionally intelligent and has such a vested interest in grammar. That's because Lordy, or Lord, I don't know how it's pronounced, is actually a 40-something-year-old woman who faked her age to sell herself as a music prodigy.
Wow. Wow.
That's all there is to that one. Apparently, she did produce a birth certificate that looked doctored.
Wow. And all everybody that she went to school with?
See, yeah, again, you're easily debunking these. Like, if you came on the scene, like, imagine if, Ruben, you just hit it big one day.
Yeah.
And you're 41 right now. So you're Lordy's...
We got this podcast.
Yeah, yeah. We're big right now. As you can see, we have no live viewers. Imagine if you said, well, I want to reach a younger audience.
Sure, yeah.
So I'm going to fake my age. Nobody would believe you. Because people would be like, no, Ruben, we graduated together and, you know, like...
Sure.
Yeah. But anyways, that's the conspiracy theory.
Okay. Moving on.
Here's one here. That Stevie Wonder, is he really blind? I'm going to show you a quick video here. And this is why I was important that I wanted to have this up. Yeah. So that our audience can see it too. So then this video here, they're performing with Paul McCartney, who comes up later. Don't say... Paul McCartney knocks over the microphone and Stevie Wonder reaches out to grab it.
Hilarious.
Let's see. So here's the video. Oops, go back further. What do you think there, Rube? Interesting. It's interesting.
Sure. Yeah, there's a reason why...
Any thoughts?
What's the benefit of him pretending he's blind?
I don't know. I have a theory about debunking this one, if you want to debunk this video here. There's another video, or a picture of him taking a picture of Michael Jackson. Have you seen that one? He's taking a picture of Michael Jackson. Steve Wonder's holding the camera and taking a picture of Michael Jackson.
No.
And there's... I think there is... Apparently there was like rehearsal. They did a lot of rehearsals. Uh-huh. And I think my theory is he was putting his hand out to give Paul McCartney a high five as he was going by. But Paul McCartney knocked the microphone over. And so he was saying... Like, hey, what up, Paul, as he runs by him? Because they did rehearsals, and we knew that he was going to the piano at that moment.
All right, so how old's Stevie?
I don't know how old he is.
He's got to be about 70, right?
Yeah.
So, for 50 to 70 years, he's going to keep this a secret? Everybody that he's around, everybody that he's, like, every marriage or girlfriend that didn't work out?
Yeah, yeah, I know. But that's the conspiracy theory.
Sure.
Yeah, are you enjoying this list so far? Are you?
I am. It's just.
Are you on board with any of these things?
No, not even remotely.
Okay. All right. Well, here. Let's see if we can find. Here we go. So here's the picture of Stevie Wonder taking a picture of Michael Jackson. Where did it go? Well, it's right here.
Sure. Yeah.
There. He's taking.
Yeah, but someone's taking a picture of him doing that. So if he was pretending to be blind,
I think it's just a joke.
Just having some fun.
Yeah. All right. Ready for the next one?
I am.
All right. This one. Britney Spears is a George Bush operative. Okay. I know you're hearing all these for the first time.
I am.
I've seen this list before.
Yes.
And I've seen the videos on YouTube for many of these.
The support.
These are legitimate. These aren't made up conspiracy theories. People have put a lot of...
They're made up.
Right. People put a lot of thought into these things. So the theory is that Brittany was on the White House payroll, and every time the Bush administration screwed up, they distracted the sheeple with another Brit scandal.
Oh, okay.
Right. Okay. All right.
Wow.
Yeah. Okay. Any thoughts on that one?
I think that anybody's entitled to their opinion, but she's like, what, 16, 17, 18 at the time?
Yeah, she was young. She sounded very young there.
Yeah.
So anyways, that was what people...
So because she supported the president there, and then she had breakdowns, she's an operative.
Exactly.
Wow, she's really committed.
She is committed.
So well, she did get committed.
Yeah, she did. That was pre-Baldhead. All right, the next theory is that Keanu Reeves is immortal.
Yeah, I have seen...
Okay, so this is the first one you've seen.
Yeah, I have seen. There's a lot of old pictures of, like, paintings where it looks like Keanu Reeves.
Yeah, right here.
Yeah.
So the first one is... the first one here is Charlemagne. Look, that's...
that's not remotely.
No, that one's
not. I could see
but
why.
But this one here, Paul Mounet. That's pretty legit.
It's close.
Okay. So, but my question is, and look at the Wikipedia entry here. He currently acts under the pseudonym of Keanu Reeves.
Bravo.
The source of his eternal youth is not known.
Oh, kudos to them for putting that in Wikipedia.
But the reason why this doesn't work, though, for a few reasons, is he's immortal, but he ages. We saw him in Bill and Ted's Excellent Adventure.
Yeah, absolutely.
So... he just looks good for his age. That's my guess for conspiracy.
Yes, I imagine that's
true. Because he has aged.
Uh-huh.
Do immortals age?
Because
in this photo here, he doesn't look like Bill and Ted young, right? So he went younger again?
Yes.
Okay. All right.
It makes no sense.
It makes no sense. All right, the next one. Now, this one, Ruben, is a little... Have you heard of this one?
Yeah, I have.
Okay, so
it's been a while, though.
So the CIA murdered Bob Marley because he and other reggae musicians were working to alert the public of the CIA's attempt to bring down Jamaican Prime Minister Michael Manley. Now, out of all the conspiracies thus far, this one holds some water, some truth, sure. Because he did do that. He was against that happening.
Yeah.
And the CIA, I don't know what the reasons were, what their interest was in this situation. So, but Bob Marley was a political irritant, to say the least.
Yeah.
That's what musicians do. Apparently, what happened was he died of cancer. Now, you say, well, he died of cancer. But he died of cancer 2 to 3 years after a certain incident happened where there was like a rusty screw or nail put into his boot. And he put his boot on. And people were convinced that the boot was spiked with some sort of cancer-forming agent that killed him.
I don't know about the boot part. And I don't know about the cancer part.
Well, that's how he died, was cancer.
Sure.
And apparently he put on his boot and was like, what was that type thing? And everyone's like, well, what's... And there's a screw in my boot and it punctured his skin. But that's the conspiracy. That's where it comes from.
Well, I don't want to say anything political. As a cancer survivor myself, I don't want to be targeted again.
Yeah, Ruben, check your boots next time you...
All right. I don't put it... it's not beneath the CIA to not knock somebody off.
Now, this one I do a little bit of digging to understand what was going on. But here's the conspiracy theory.
Uh-huh.
That Beyonce essentially is... she's 5 years older to 6 years older than she says she is.
Okay.
Okay. And that Solange, I don't say her name right, Solange Knowles?
I don't think there's an E pronounced then. I think it's Solange.
Solange?
Perhaps.
That she is Beyonce's daughter. That they actually have a 14-year gap between them, not six.
Okay.
And that she had her when she was 14.
Okay. So when you look at the Destiny Child's like home videos when they're all practicing.
Mm-hmm.
And they're all, like, younger and all the same age. It's like it's just a bunch of teenage girls together. That kind of throws it in a wrench.
Yeah, I don't know enough of her age that she was supposed to be when she was in Destiny's Child.
But I've seen...
But maybe she just looked younger but was older is what I'm getting at.
But she was shorter.
Who, Beyonce?
Yeah, like, what's this head? What's his name? Knowles. Beyonce's father.
Yeah, I don't know. It's Jackson Knowles?
I saw some, like, Destiny's Child, like, bio thing.
Okay.
And they were, like, teenage girls practicing in the living room. And Mr. Knowles, you know, had, just like any father, had video.
Okay.
You know, videos of their kids, like, dancing and, like going to the malls and that sort of stuff.
All right, so I'm not too sure about this one either. So apparently they're mother and daughter, not sisters. That's the theory.
Yeah.
That's the conspiracy. All right. I don't know enough, but check this one out. This is, we know that Beyonce and Kanye have two kids together, but the theory is,
I feel like three.
Or two or three. Three, I maybe know. Now. But the conspiracy theory is that Beyonce was never pregnant, at least with Blue. That she faked the pregnancy that was actually surrogate that did have the baby, so it was still their egg and sperm.
Sure.
But she never carried the baby.
That's believable.
How you doing? I'm good. It's a beautiful baby bump. No wonder Beyonce is blooming. This really is Destiny's Child. Really is Destiny's Child.
That's pretty good. Look.
Yeah, somebody 9 months pregnant isn't...
And then she goes, this is this look right here at the end. So, I kind of... That's physical evidence. Have you ever seen a pregnant woman's stomach do that when they bend over? It never flattens that I've ever seen.
I'm a father.
Have you seen that?
No. So I would say that's pretty probable.
Okay. That's a probable one?
Everything that we've seen, I think that's the most probable.
Okay. Good. I was hoping you'd be behind this one. Okay, this one might be a little bit interesting. This one basically, as you know, Tupac's alive. You've probably heard this before.
Oh, yeah. Okay. I was texting with him just on the way here.
So here is the proof that he is alive.
Right on cue. Watch. Started with the, started. With the raid. Enter the Tupac in the background. The
says you can't be here at night and all the rest of it.
Yeah.
Can you believe what you're seeing?
The great song.
Dances right past the screen. Can you believe that?
Okay.
Okay, first of all, Tupac's a short little man.
I don't know how tall he is. Now, we gotta be very careful here. I personally have a theory.
Okay.
That's not Tupac. That just might be somebody that looks like Tupac.
Sure, there's doppelgangers.
Well, yeah, that's the whole point.
I had a woman come home to work yesterday, and I got starstruck.
You got starstruck?
Yeah. Why? I thought it was Melissa Joan Hart.
From Sabrina?
Yes, Sabrina the Teenage Witch. I'm like, holy crap, she's in my store. And then I'm like, oh, no, wait. That's not her.
No, that's not her.
But that was like, you know, a foot in front of my face type of thing.
So the theory is that he escaped to Cuba.
Uh-huh.
From his increasingly dangerous celebrity status. And yet he decided to show up here. All right.
I personally don't think that was...
Of course, you remember this one, right? The theory that Marissa Tomei's Oscar win was flub by Jack Palance at the Oscars. That apparently he read the teleprompter and said the wrong name. And before it was too late, the award was given. Now, I found the clip where he reads her name, but he's looking down at the envelope, not the teleprompter. But maybe he memorized the teleprompter and looked at the envelope. Who knows?
Is he still alive?
No, he's passed.
Oh, rest in peace, Jack.
For the best performance by an actress in a supporting role, the Oscar goes to...
Hilarious.
And the Oscar goes to Marissa Tomei. See? My cousin.
He almost sounded like he questioned himself there. Did you hear that? Marissa Tomei. I don't know. But the thing is, even when people saw this live, they never... No one said she shouldn't have won. The conspiracy theories came out... This is pre-internet, too, by the way.
Okay.
So, they came out, like, right away. The rumblings were happening throughout... Because this is, you know, it's a small business in its own right.
Sure.
That people were like, that wasn't supposed to be here. Apparently, it was supposed to be... I forget who it was supposed to be. It doesn't matter. I forget what the who the nominations were. But, yeah, it wasn't supposed to be her. And that's just kind of been... Yeah. Yeah.
I love Marissa Tomei.
Of course, I owe many, many thanks... to the cast and crew of My Cousin Vinny.
And to Jack Palance for saying my name wrong?
Sure, sure.
All right. So what do you think? Do you think... So it says here, the March 2294 Hollywood Reporter article, which reads, a rumor is currently making the rounds in Manhattan, fanned by no less than the former son-in-law of a distinguished Academy Award winner, to wit that last year Marissa Tomei received her Oscar statue by error, with a resultant scandal about it soon to be exposed, much to the shame of the Academy.
Okay, but did it get exposed?
No, it didn't.
So it's one of those things where it's like Trump saying, oh, I've done some research on Obama. He was born in Kenya. Yeah, some people, you know what I mean? Just always dangling that carrot, and then it just never happens. That's like the...
Yeah.
It's the calling card of a conspiracy theory. These unexposed things, somebody saying it. This is, what, 20 years ago?
I'm going to ignore this one, Ruben. It's the... well, here's a theory, but I didn't even understand it when I read it, and I watched this video, and basically that... The conspiracy is that her and Tom Hiddleston aren't really a couple. But it says here, the theory is that Taylor Swift cheated on Calvin Harris, I guess her boyfriend, and used the Tom Hiddleston relationship to cover it up. I don't understand by using a relationship you're covering up a cheat. I'm confused by that sentence in general. How?
I don't know.
Okay. And I
also don't really...
I don't care either.
Do you know who Calvin Harris is?
Who's Calvin Harris?
He's a DJ.
Okay. All right. All right. That one doesn't interest me, and it's stupid, so I'm going to ignore that one. Here we don't have any video. The video was broken, but...
Part of it.
Have you heard of this one, Ruben?
Yes.
That Stanley Kubrick, after filming 2001 A Space Odyssey, was asked by the U.S. government to fake the moon landing in 69. That it was a film set, and he was the director. Thoughts?
Anything's possible. But I kind of think that... it happened.
The moon landing itself happened? We talked about this on our conspiracy episode. So you think it did happen?
Okay. I do.
All right. My understanding
I wouldn't be surprised if I was wrong.
Right. We talked about this where I think with the moon landing, I'm still on the fence. I could be just as... If I found out that they faked the moon landing, I'd be like, yeah, okay. As much as if it was real, I'd be, yeah, okay. I'm almost indifferent, I guess is what I'm saying.
Yeah, I'm not vested in it.
Some people are. However, I do still think they filmed practice footage, and at the very least, they probably used Kubrick, a very famous film director, and knows how to use equipment, saying...
It's plausible.
Yeah, okay. So I think maybe the two things are getting mixed. All right, here's a good one. Did you hear this one?
That JonBenet is
Katie... JonBenet.
JonBenet, sorry. Yeah.
So JonBenet was a young girl who was murdered... Right under her parents' nose, who got off scot-free in 1996. But she actually grew up to be multi-platinum recording artist Katy Perry.
Okay. So for that to happen, all of her parents and relatives...
Yes.
All had to be... Yeah.
So here's a picture comparison of JonBenet, bless her heart, as a young child. And here's Katy Perry somewhat near today.
I don't see it.
Yeah. Well, you can even just look at the nose here. She's got a very, like, kind of a curved...
She probably just got plastic surgery.
Yeah.
And what would be the purpose of pretending...
I don't know. And this is another one, Ruben, where people would be like, I knew Katy Perry as a child, and she was never JonBenet. All right. But that is a theory all the same that made the rounds on the internet. Okay.
All right.
We saved the best for last.
Oh, good.
Paul McCartney is dead.
Yes, yes.
And this kind of falls into the same kind of category as the one at the beginning of Avril Lavigne had died in the peak of her career.
Sure.
And they got a replacement for her because of the big business of having this artist. Well, Paul McCartney also died in the height of the Beatles' career, and the company's like, record companies was like, we got to get a replacement for...
Sure.
If there's ever a time to pull off this, it would have been in the 60s, before the internet, before... being able to review footage and people only saw them on grainy black and white.
Yeah, yeah.
You know what I mean by that?
Yeah,
you could almost pull it off. This is a great little video here. If you guys want to Google it on YouTube and watch it on your own, it's a few minutes long, but it's called Paul's Dead - The Shocking Clues Collection. I'm just going to see if I can find some of the backmasking of some of their songs where they say Paul is dead. Have you seen that?
I have heard...
Here we go.
All our messages were subliminal, you know. Meaning we were sending messages out, all right, but...
Yeah, but what kinds of messages?
Just reporting on the state we were in, you know, looking back on it.
Number nine. There you go. That's the backmasking. So that was I forget which song that came from, but they didn't say which song it came from, but that's on YouTube all over the place, where you backmask, sure, or backplay. It says Paul's dead, man. Miss him. Why would that exist?
I think if you're looking for something, you're gonna find it.
Okay.
Opposed to...
And there's a couple clips in this video as well.
Where they also found somebody that sounds like him, looks like him.
Yes.
Of his family is on board with this.
Well, that's the big thing. I mean, I'm not saying I believe it, but that's the big thing. There's a couple...
But then keep making music as a solo artist.
Right. Well, it's money. You got a whole career plan for
he's
you.
He's a billionaire.
Yeah, he's a billionaire. But check out this clip, though. This is interesting. This actually has nothing to do with the... But they threw it in, but check this creepy clip out.
From information I received while using a Ouija board, I believe that there will be an attempt to assassinate you. The spirit that gave me this information was Brian Epstein. He said the attempt would be made in place of March 6th, 70, and Mr. Epstein also said that Paul McCartney was alive in London.
Huh? Weird, eh? Nah, you could argue any celebrity could have this.
Sure, yeah.
When did he get killed, though? Was it March 6th?
I don't know.
Do you want to Google that?
Yeah.
So, Ruben, that is all of our celebrity conspiracies.
Yes. Or is it all of them?
Yeah, well, all the ones we're covering today. Do you have one? Now, for the worst, I thought that the criteria could be maybe a combination of least plausible. Okay. Well, actually, however you want it. I'm going to go with the most least plausible, and what are they thinking?
Sure.
So, we got Avril Lavigne, Lord... Blind, Stevie Wonder, Britney Spears, Operative, Keanu Reeves, Bob Marley, Murder, Beyonce, Tupac, Marissa Tomei, and the Moon Landing, JonBenet Perry, and Paul McCartney. I'll give you my pick first.
Sure. Now, before I get the pick, though, John Lennon died December 8th.
Okay, so it wasn't March 6th.
Yeah.
Okay. He did get assassinated, but wrong date.
Yeah.
Right crime, wrong date. I'm going with the Keanu Reeves one. I'm going with the pick of the most... If I had to pick the worst plausible... He's not immortal.
I have one... Okay.
That's my reason. That's my reasoning.
Okay.
Least plausible of all these is that... No, he is aging and he will die one day.
I think it's more plausible that Keanu Reeves is immortal.
Oh, wow.
Than Britney Spears is a government operative.
That's a tough call. All right. All right. So Ruben believes that there's a chance. You're saying there's a chance above.
I am.
Okay.
I am.
Well, there you go, folks. I hope you enjoyed today's episode of The Worst of the Best of the Greatest Celebrity Conspiracies of All Time. And remember, in front of every cloud, there's a silver lining, and we're here to help you find it. Thanks for watching. How do I turn this off again?
Boom, boom, boom. Good stuff.
Okay.
That's fun.
I'm glad I figured it out. Stop streaming. Stop recording. Thanks for being patient with me. You got time for at least two more?
Oh, yeah.
Okay. You don't work tomorrow or nothing?
Nope.